guys, it's my first video, and I decided to play Oxenfree. I have played this once before, so, yeah, I mean, you can get different endings, I think, so every time I do play, it's a different ending. Yeah, I think I'm playing this because I think there's meant to be a new Oxenfree game out, I think. I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, without further ado, let's go. Preserve the time. Start Oxenfree over with extended content enabled. Erase all the data and start Oxenfree from the beginning. You know, I might as well. I can always just start away with it and then continue the timeline again. I don't think it sort of does all that matter. Let's just restart the timeline. I'm not sure if it actually makes much of a big deal. Let's go. So what does it say? Play. My camera is blocking the buttons.
It used to be a military base. Well, it used to be a ranching thing, then it was turned into an army thing, then it became a bird thing and a museum or whatever. Henry Fonda stationed here, I think, for a bit. Unless he was Navy.
Who's Henry Fonda?
Around Christmas time, this little breakfast place used to sell these amazing polar bear sugar cookies. Man! Those were good. And then one year they changed the formula or whatever and ruined it. Alex? Hey, still with us? You haven't said anything for like 10 minutes.
I can watch the hypnotic rolling of the waves and listen to you at the same time.
Oh, okay. What did I say? Little miss, I can see and hear things
sometime
at the same time.
A bird island or whatever.
Cookies are great on Edward's Island.
Used to be great, but you passed. Thank you.
Okay.
So you all moved in?
I love the graphics.
Not really. I just got in this morning.
And how did her mom meet your dad exactly?
They met on vacation in Orlando. He got lost in a... You know, actually, I'm not even going to tell this story. It's really not worth it.
Okay.
Oh, damn.
Yes, please don't. Let's not relive their meet-cute any more than we have to.
And you guys just met tonight?
Yeah, I was, I'd been out of school, and the timing had just never worked out, so...
And what? Does that make you to her, then? Hey, second cousin?
Just some guy.
I don't know how people math works.
He's just a brother.
Oh, yeah. I forgot that was even a thing. Well, at least you seem cool, right? Cool guy, cool hat. You get a cool new sibling living right in your house. Sharing your toothbrush.
No,
wearing your clothes.
Weird.
Eating your...
No, that's the weird part. I mean, isn't it like... The concept of just getting a new sister like a puppy, isn't it kind of awkward?
No, it's been totally bizarre. But just for the record, I don't consider you a pet.
So, I'm not
so how do you two know each other?
Oh, from way back when, like Paleozoic, grade school era. Young enough that I've seen her in a bathtub and it wasn't sexual at all. I mean, we both looked like little skinned potato blobs.
Yeah, well, you don't see a man's toddler penis and not become best friends after that.
Yeah, exactly. Bond stronger than oak. check under your seat to make sure you don't leave behind any grandchildren.
Wait, who's talking right now?
The captain.
It's a recording. They always play. Oh, we should get a quick picture. All of us. This would be like the before shot.
Yeah, let's do it.
And it's Jonas.
Come in handy.
Not Jonah.
Yeah, Jonas. Like Jonas Salk?
Right, Patient Zero, AIDS guy.
It's biblical, right? Or is that the lion guy?
I think every name's biblical, so probably.
Here's good.
Wait. Wait for me,
Come on, Alex, join the fun.
Yeah, wait for me. Picture. Nice.
There, great. I'll magic erase all the warts out and stuff, so don't worry. Hey, Alex, you brought the radio, right? The little portable one?
Of course.
Perfect. Can you pull it out a second?
All right. Control.
There's the little guy. Our high school has a radio station, and Carly, she's a friend of ours. She's filling in because Reggie got mono from some track runner or something. It doesn't matter. What matters is that she's going to say something like, basically, right now, about our thing. So, tune into 88.3 so I can tell her we heard it.
Sorry, Ren. Not interested.
Which I played because that song's been stuck in my head since I woke up this morning. But, actually, it's a little after 10 o'clock, which means my dear friend Ren and his buddies are probably just touching down on Edwards Island for the yearly bash on the beach, or whatever we call it now. But anyways, I promised him that I'd play a song from his band, so hope you're listening, Ren. Here are the Red-Headed Bedwetters with Baby Carrots.
That's awesome. I hope Christina, with her talent show judge face, was listening. We must be getting close. There's no radio reception on the island. I'm glad I got to hear it before it went totally kaput.
If we can't use it, why'd you bring it? Not just for the boat.
No. You'll see. I don't expect too much, but nah, it'll be fun. I won't undercook it. You'll see.
Ooh. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Nice picture. I do like the cartoon, like drawing style. It's very nice.
Smell that clean air, boys and girls. Boy and girl.
Ooh,
this ain't city living.
Yeah, anybody need a smoke? I have a full pack.
No thanks. I mean, I literally just said the clean air thing, so...
Alex, you can bum one off me if you're empty. I forget if you're a fellow addict.
Oh, you know what? She doesn't smoke either, so...
Okay, just checking.
All right, my other friend should be up and around the bend.
Actually, that... I mean, I don't mean to be the guy to break us up already, but Ren, can you do me a favor? Can I have, like, 2 real quick minutes with Alex for a second? And you can, you know, you can run up and meet your friends?
Really?
Wait, is something wrong? What is it?
Nothing's wrong. It'll just take 2 minutes, super fast.
All right, bud. look, I don't want to go up by myself.
No,
I mean, can't we just stick together?
Him.
You're gonna have all night to say, like, whatever.
But since you want to meet up with your friends anyway...
We're all gonna meet up with them.
No, it's fine, Ren. Go on up ahead and we'll catch up with you.
Okay. I guess. Though this is a really strange way to start off, splitting up.
It'll be fast. Thanks, man.
I'll just be up the hill, in case... whatever.
Ren seems nice. He's funny, you know?
He knows me.
Reminds me of a guy I know back home.
I don't know. He sometimes gets on my nerves.
Listen, I just wanted to grab you ahead of time and say you've been cool about everything. And I guess it's just for me, I've never moved anywhere. And, like, getting a new family at the same time kind of feels like I'm skipping the training wheels. Not that it's been bad or anything. You and your mom have been great.
Yeah. Sure you miss your friends.
He doesn't.
Eh, There's not much to miss, to be honest. Oh, and thanks for setting up the attic for me. It's cool how it's like a little bedroom. I was in the basement at my
old... Yeah, no problem. Anytime.
No probs. No probs, probs. You were in jail?
I heard, I think from my mom that you,
went to jail? Yeah, well, don't believe everything you hear. We can catch back up with Ren now. I didn't mean to take so long.
Alright, let's catch up. Let's catch up with Ren. Oh, can we see what's on here? No. Okay. What's this store?
It's kinda kitschy. Right? It's kinda kitschy.
Yeah, it's like a quiche.
Quiche? Like the food?
I think they block this off at night since nobody needs to use it. Or maybe they just had a parade?
Sure, either one.
Wait, I want to see what this car's about. A bit mysterious.
If nobody lives here and the stores are all closed, whose car is this?
Mm. Oh, there's always that one lonely car in every parking lot.
Sus. Bit sus, I think. Alright, here's a radio. Alright. Just get used to using the radio a bit.
Named after the Hawaiian god of the sea, the USS Kanaloa was launched on January 15, 1941, and commissioned into service at the end of that year under the command of Lieutenant James Earl Clapman. On October 28, 1943, it was sunk by the Japanese sub-chaser Tokusai, some 25 miles off the coast of Hawaii, and remains, to this day, the only submarine casualty in American waters. 85 officers...
God, this was even here. It's a monument to some submarine that was sunk off the coast.
Oh, do the radio guide thing they talked about on the boat, you know? It's what, like 102.3?
Okay, sure.
Just
I think they said it's 102.3.
Named after the Hawaiian god of the sea, the USS Kanaloa was launched on January 15, 1941, and commissioned into service at the end of that year under the command of Lieutenant James Earl Clapman.
Kind of creepy in a way, right?
On October 28, 1943, it was sunk by the... Named after...
Alright, be quiet. I'll be quiet. What? How? Park office.
Parks and facilities office. Ren's sister Allison used to work there. You'd like her. She's tall.
Alright.
I don't have any other things to say about this person except their height. That's concerning.
Damn. They close up early.
I guess no point in staying open if nobody's here.
True.
That's true.
Hello, kids. Look, the other guys and gals must be further up, so be quick now. Okay, speed read definition of Edwards Island. This is a tourist trap with shops and a beach. Nobody lives here except for some geriatric named Mrs. Adler. But, as God is my witness, we'll never mention her or any other old person's name again. We are here to drink and be stupid, a tradition apparently started by bored recruits in the 1950s who would sneak dates over from the coastal towns. They literally called it trawling. The beaten path officially ends here.
Press
the beach
something.
Is past the fence. I think Jerry told me that there's a way.
Why is it telling me?
It used to get.
Oh, wait, hang on. Oh, this is the map. Okay. Ooh, pictures already. Huh. Cool.
Over there, but I'm blanking on what it was. But it's not. I mean, it can't be too difficult.
Perfect.
Well, just wait a minute and let me think. So, to summarize, we are not allowed here after dark.
I think the dumpster will get us over if it'll budge.
Well, let's try it.
Let's give it a whirl.
Anyways, the town's youths keep the whole slink over camp thing alive and well.
No, I got it.
Imposter act.
Isn't this supposed to be like a giant swarming animal mask wearing freakout? Where's everybody else?
Jesus, Alex, it's just supposed to be like a somewhat oversized kegger, and I think more people are coming. And the other thing is the weirdo caves.
Weirdo caves?
The whole reason Alex brought her radio is because when you go to the... It's like the front.
The mouth
of this particular cave, you can sometimes pick up frequencies to stations that don't exist. You'll hear voices, or just...
It's pretty creepy. At least I've heard.
I did it once. It's amazing when it works.
How? So back up a second. Who's going? Mrs. Adler?
Her family, owns some of the island or something. She's been shacked in the same spot for like 70 years.
I think I said that earlier. Never mind.
Before we get there, I should mention that.
Oh god.
Who's that?
There's this girl, Nona. She's
Rider?
Just this girl, and I'm totally into her, and I want her to be into me. So just, you know, just be cool, okay? No pouting or complaining or anything, all right?
Be cool.
Deal? Be cool.
Don't be like, just how you. What? What's going on? Should I be scared?
Some birds flew out of a hole
just
and scared me.
Just nature.
Birds. Cheep, cheep, cheep. You big goof.
Yeah, you goof.
This data command annex, as it had been dubbed, was used during the base's early years as the communication nerve center for outside military installations.
Hmm.
It was also the primary office of...
Hey, is this like a part of the base? This far out on the beach?
I honestly don't know what that is. But remember, you can pull out your little radio and tune to that tour station
that
if you want.
Oh, that's end. Okay. Let go to the beach. Run. Okay, let's... No, we are going down here. Wait, isn't this the path? Right? Oh, no, it's over here. Never mind. Jump. I do like Alex's hair, I'm not gonna lie.
Reginald, I hear you over there.
Hey, guys.
Wait, I was about to tell a story. What was it?
About Brad's car.
Oh, well, that can wait.
Hey.
We started a fire down the way, but Nona wanted to play beach nanny, so...
Yeah. Hi.
Hi.
And Jonas, that's...
Who are you?
Jonas.
That's Jonas. He's Alex's new in town, fresh as the daisy, stepbrother.
Stepbrother?
Really?
Yeah, I know. It's a trip, right?
Yes, it
is. Yeah, this is his first night here, so everybody be on your best behavior. Treat him as you would a scary dog. Palms out.
That's,
be on edge.
I don't bite.
Be scared.
It's fine.
Wait. You're Jonas. Jonas, the stepbrother.
Yeah. What's your name again?
That is Clarissa.
How
but
are
she's...
you a stepbrother? Like, what does that even mean?
My mom married his dad, so family law and all.
Yeah, well, I guess this is happening now. This is a thing that is happening, so... Where's everyone else?
Nicole had that tennis thing.
And?
Who else was supposed to come?
Anyone? Everyone?
Oh, well,
Clarissa, we...
She does not
we took the last ferry. I thought more would show up, but...
Oh my god, it's just Alex and her new stepbrother? That's it. That's who you brought. That's the group.
Come on, Clarissa. I'm fun. I'm hip. I'm with it.
Listen to yourself.
Wait, aren't you all, like, friends?
I'm friends with Nona, and I'm downgrading Ren to, like, a creepy neighbor. And you, I just met.
Hey, what about me?
What about you?
What about me? Oh, I keep pressing it. It's not registering. Really a bad ending. I already know it. So many load screens.
Fire! Man's great equalizer.
So, what's the, like, thing to do here? Other than obviously go skinny dipping and get murdered by Jason Krueger.
Yeah, let's just get drunk. It's supposed to be a party, right?
Hey, where does that old woman live?
That was the worst skinny.
You mean Maggie Adler?
Yeah.
Nowhere. She's dead.
What?
Yep, killed over 3 days ago. It was all over the news. Local news, anyway. Oldest living resident.
Hey, we could go see her house. It must be huge. She was rich as...
No, we can't see her house. There's a giant fence, and I don't want to tear my jeans trying to climb it. And to answer your previous question, Jonas, the thing to do is lay on the beach and drink till you can't remember where you are.
Well, that is depressing.
And sometimes play truth or slap.
Yeah, let's play that.
And that's
we can inaugurate Jonas. Ease him into the night's festivities.
Truth or slap? What's that?
We used to call it hippo, until we got tired of people asking, why is it called hippo?
Because you get to yell, you're a dirty hippo, before you slap someone.
You get asked a question. You have to tell the truth, but if somebody can prove that you lied, the accuser gets to slap you. It's a good, getting to know somebody game.
Unless you lie a lot.
How can you prove that somebody lied?
Hearsay, rumor, conjecture, the usual.
All right, let's just get on with it.
Okay, so, first, we're gonna...
I'll start. Brett.
Uh-huh.
Come on, fess up. You wanna go out with Nona, right?
Clarissa!
Wait, I wanna...
Okay, that's...
Ask something instead.
Clarissa, you know what? Ask me something instead. Anything you want.
You'll get your turn after Reginald answers the question.
Look, it's tough to gauge. Something like...
Enough stalling. I know you want to sample the goods. Now
no.
Just face it.
I mean, I like her as a friend, right? That's... I just like her as a friend. That's all. She's cool. She's just a friend.
He's lying.
Liar! He's lying! He totally likes her!
What? Alex, come on. What are you doing?
I knew it. You can practically smell...
I'm kidding. Relax. Last I heard, he's still pining for Lindsay, his secret Canadian girlfriend.
Yeah, well, I have a thing for hockey, so...
Sure.
Okay, it's Ren's turn, right? He gets to ask somebody something?
Alex!
Uh-oh.
Little man.
Oh, please. Shoot, I can take it.
Okay. Mary Screwkill. Me, Nona, and Clarissa.
Why?
It's fun.
Okay,
it's funny,
Clarissa.
I don't know. And Jonas is family now, technically, so he's excluded.
I'd marry Nona. I like the quiet types.
I'm flattered, I think.
Okay, you're going down the line. Who'd you do the dirty with?
Clarissa, obviously.
Obviously. You're not going to call her out on that?
No, I believe her. I mean, look at me.
And wait. Wait, that means you'd kill me? Out of everyone here, your best friend.
You are.
And I'm the only guy.
It.
This is Miss Andrew. Miss Andrew, I say.
Okay, settle down.
I'll kill Ben.
So, Alex's turn?
Yep, lady's choice. Alex gets to pick who to ask something of.
Oh, great. Here we go. What's your favorite stuffed animal? Professor
Nona.
Nona.
Yes.
Do you like Ren?
All right, let's make it something...
Do I Ren?
Like Ren?
Oh, Jesus. Can we just stop with the whole me and Nona thing, please?
Of course she doesn't. She barely likes anybody. She's like an amoeba.
No?
One day, she'll reproduce in a cloud of spores.
No? Not even a little bit?
You don't have to answer.
I like Ren like a friend. Like, he's a nice guy. You're a nice guy. And we goof off and, yeah, you know.
Ta-da! All is right with the world.
Oh, shut up.
Nona, you're up?
Oh. Clarissa. If you had to get a tattoo, what would it be?
A chick riding a motorcycle on fire.
A better question would be, what would she get when the artist refused to draw two dogs eating a dead baby on her forehead?
I'd get, like, a little ampersand on my ring finger. I think I actually am going to get that after I move out, so my parents can't say no.
Neat. Clarissa's turn now.
Alex, you got a new brother. Pretty exciting. I'm sure Jonas is excited, or maybe excited isn't the right word. Maybe a little overwhelmed with just everything, you know? Unsure. It's a lot to take in and adjust to.
I'm, fine with it.
What's your point, Clarissa?
I'm just saying what Jonas is already thinking. That statistics show if you get divorced once, you're probably gonna get divorced again. And the fact is, your mom divorced your dad, so let's put his mind at ease and hear why.
I don't really need to know.
What are you talking about? What is this even? What does this have to do with anything?
Why did your parents get a divorce? Just so Jonas can hear it from you.
Clarissa, I don't really care why they got a divorce. Just that Alex's mom is happy.
Isn't fair. Like, at all.
Of course it's fair. Why'd your parents get divorced? I know you know why.
Fine.
My brother Michael died, and it broke everything, and they couldn't handle it. The end.
Well, now you know, Jonas. Don't die, and everything will be fine.
Okay, Clarissa, you...
What?
You know, guys, honestly, I think I'm pretty much ready to do anything else besides this game.
Clarissa's the villain.
Wait, let's not stop like this. We should, like...
Game's over, Ren. I won. And to celebrate,
oh,
I'm gonna sit on the beach and drink, and maybe, if I'm feeling spicy, even take a nap.
Maybe we could
and
get...
And that's exactly what Nona's gonna do, too.
You're so
oh
annoying.
My god, you're annoying.
This isn't me being annoying. This is me being tired. There's a difference. Cheese! If you guys in your scavenger hunt or playing Ring Around the Rosie happen to find anything more interesting than a slowly dying starfish, you be sure
yeah,
to just let
actually,
me know.
Super.
Sure, we'll grab you if we find any,
Island Bigfoots?
Island Bigfoots, exactly.
Well, I want to inaugurate this bitch by checking out the caves. No one
yeah,
want to come.
That's what I was doing.
I mean, I would.
I'm very clingy, Ren.
Fine. Jonas, you're a strapping young lad. Help boost me over the fence. The cave's just, yonder.
And I guess you expect me to just jump over after?
But like I said, you're a strapping young lad.
Okay, come on.
Where are you from again?
It's a small town near North Valley.
Oh, yeah. Is it nice?
If you like bars on the windows. Alex, you want to check out the caves, or?
Yeah,
let's do it. Boost me up?
Yeah, come on.
Going the wrong way.
Come on,
oh,
I'll push you over.
I forgot, we never talked about John.
Whenever you're ready.
What, their date?
Oh, come
yeah,
on.
He,
Unless I get a crink in my back, which
how do you
might
get
happen if
house?
You don't go soon.
Jonas.
So what
back.
Happened?
They just, it was funny. I guess they tried ordering drinks and they like, she wanted something
oh,
like
Lord,
a named thing.
Oh why is she going
thing?
Step by step?
Oh god.
Yeah, like a, some weird cocktail or something. And they didn't know what she was talking about. And John, of course, is all nervous. And they basically got kicked out, so they didn't even get to see any of
right,
like, the stuff.
That's, yeah. Of course that's how it went.
Now we're cooking.
So,
the last time
the cave. Here? What's your bets? On a scale of 1 to 10, how weird's it gonna be?
Oh, very weird.
It's Ren,
yeah.
So definitely 10. He gets excited
ooh, wait,
easily, but he has the concentration of a goldfish. The fact that he keeps demanding we see it must mean something.
Alright.
Hey, Chris seems to be her normal annoying self. Sorry about that.
It's not your fault. I think somebody dumped pig's blood on her in a previous life, and now she just wants to get ahead of the curve.
Yeah, probably. Thanks for, not ratting me out to Nona during the game. I didn't think you would, but, you know, you could've, and you didn't, so thanks.
Well, you can make the checks out to cash. We'll have an installment plan.
Whatever it takes. Now, who's ready to have their minds blown?
If you don't mean that literally,
just tell
I
me what
am...
to do.
Just get on with it. What do I do?
Oh, wait. Actually,
sorry,
I almost forgot.
It's
gonna take a little magic trip to Cupcake Town.
Ooh.
Those look like brownies.
Magic? What does that
oh
mean?
Oh my god.
It means they're
he's
enhanced with certain qualities.
Well, maybe just don't eat too much.
Yo, what was that? God, you don't even give a guy some warning. This is the thing. Sorry. You tune into these rocks and this weird stuff happens. It's really... It's...
How is this... How can this be possible?
Maybe the tuning's like unblocking a weather balloon or something?
It doesn't make any sense.
Well, it's just crazy, Ben. Because I don't know. If you move around, it kind of changes too, I think. Like, over at this pile. Here, come over here and try it.
Master Wren. Right. Oh, the numbers are red.
This is so cool. I know! Clarissa and Nona should see this, right?
I know it's weird with you guys, for some reason, but...
They're fine where they are.
Forget it.
Okay, just what is Clarissa's issue with you two?
She dated
Michael for 5 seconds, like 3 years ago.
It was for a couple of months, a year and a half ago.
Whatever, she never liked me. Not even then. I was always the little sister who got in the way, who she had to climb in through windows to sneak around.
Clarissa's the kind of person who doesn't feel full unless she...
It sounds so...
Yeah, it sounds,
static?
Satanic.
Oh.
Not what I was gonna say.
I can read.
But close enough.
Wait, what was that? There's like, this is gonna sound stupid, but there's like something in here.
Famous last words. Famous last...
No, I see it too.
I'm sure there is something in there, like... A giant rabies-filled bat, or a maniac who wears mannequin wigs.
Or it kind of looks like a pool or something. Like a freshwater one, maybe. Let's check it out. It's not that far in.
It's a pool, that'd be cool. I, didn't mean that to rhyme.
Cool pool.
Fortune favors the bold.
Bye.
Wait a minute! Jonas!
Well, I am going to just rest against here, because I think I mismeasured the magic.
Oh my god, Ren is high. Where's that light coming from?
Jonas! Jonas!
Do I just have a light on my chest now, or... You know, anything's possible in this spot, to be honest. Alright, let's hop up. Bit of rock climbing. Rock climbing's really good, really fun. Quite enjoyable. Really enjoyable. Don't slip. Well, come on. No. What? What? Oh, do you have to get down first? Okay, hang on. There we go. Now the cookie's crumbling. Jump.
Jonas, are you alright? Shout if you're, like, bleeding or something.
Yeah, he seems very quiet. This is mysterious. Why isn't he talking? Jonas? Jonas! Where are you? Jonas! Jonas! What does this say?
Why would a guy bring an ashtray down here? Or a pen? See a man about a dog.
Here he is.
Well, didn't you hear me calling for you?
Jesus, you scared me.
Oh, I scared you? You scared me. I had no idea where you were.
I'm sorry for going ahead. I thought I heard somebody down here, but
you thought wrong.
You know, obviously there isn't. But isn't this place incredible? I mean, I don't even know how this happens.
It's honestly creeping me out. I feel like we're in Satan's underground lair.
It's a little creepy, but I mean, it's all just a cave. Just a natural cave. See? That's what I heard. It sounds like a person almost, right? Kinda? I don't know where it's coming from.
Okay, at this point, if we stay, we're just idiots, right? We're just the horror movie morons the audience screams at to leave.
There was a light in here somewhere. I still want to see what made it. It must just be for... What? Wow, how is that? Did you see the floating, triangle light thing?
Yes.
It must be like a rainbow or like a reflection of light? Those, exist, right?
Sure, why not? Let's go with that.
Save the man,
for the time being.
But not the dog.
I think this is all tied to when you tuned in those weird signals out there and the, what am I trying to say? I think that you...
Apart from the, triangle, this is honestly the craziest thing in here. Like, how did it even get in? And I mean, aside from some, like, water damage, it's not really even that junky.
I know. Try your radio. Maybe that's like a frequency or something. Like, if it'll have an effect.
Yeah, good idea. Maybe it'll dance or twitch or something.
At least something.
Oh my god. Is this you? Are you doing this?
Should I stop?
No, this is awesome. This is insane.
What? What are you...
Listen, Bobtail.
Shamtail.
Sleeping. Time.
Yeah. Is possible.
I don't know what you mean, so I can't...
Bobtail.
Leave, children.
Bye.
Others will see you
soon.
Alex!
Jonas!
Rightio. Oh, it is heating up. It's a really fun game, actually. It's quite fun. I wonder if there's actually things like this sort of things in real life. Like mysterious things that we don't know that are out there. Aliens. Spaceships.
Alex! Alex! Alex? Are you okay? You alright?
What happened?
That is a very good question. Look, I'm just gonna cut to the whatever. Like, I don't know exactly what happened back there, but the sign says that's an old communications tower, and I don't know about you, but I want to climb that ladder, call somebody, and get the hell back home as fast as possible. I don't want to be the party pooper here.
I'm way ahead of you.
I'm just saying what she's saying.
Some kind of emergency station or way to get out without taking the ferry.
Oh, and not for nothing. I'm fine with a little de-pantsing or whatever if the weather's right for it. But if this is some sort of prank or trick, I'm really, really not in the mood. So, if it is...
Christ, I'm as freaked out as you are, Jonas, all right? I have a splitting headache and, like, I feel like my fingernails are going to shoot out of my hands.
Mine too. Just cross your fingers the comm tower has a working walkie-talkie or something.
From 1941 to 1972, this communications tower served many different telecommunication functions, including point-to-point from its receivers, microwave from its dish, Ka band for satellite reception, and military air band for nearby aircraft.
Close door, bro. Well. I'd be so out of breath by the time I got to the top. I'm so unfit. So many stairs. It's like climbing a, what's it called? Lighthouse. I mean, it's all the same. It's all tall towers. Tall towers. Made for me, Jonas! Well, I'm going to leave it here. Yes, I will play some more in the next video. Meanwhile, sorry, I kind of forgot where the camera was momentarily. so thank you for watching, and I'll post a part two in... I mean, this is part one, but I'll post a part two in the next video. Stay tuned. Bye.